A few months ago, I applied for a test. Now, unfortunately, the results of this test did not come in time, which meant that I couldn't get on a flight to go and test the new Triumph Trident at its launch event in Dehradun. Now, after 3 painfully long months, Triumph has finally given us a test bike. And while sadly we don't have any glorious mountain roads to go and attack, the Trident now faces a much more strenuous real-world test. Trident is a motorcycle born to take on the highly popular entry-level middleweight naked segment in international markets. What it promises is the trademark Triumph 3-cylinder experience, but in an easy-to-ride and relatively affordable package. Walk into a Triumph showroom and you'll see that the Trident isn't just the most affordable bike they have on sale, it's also the most compact, even when compared with a Street Triple. That feeling continues when you sit on the bike. From what I'm seeing and feeling right now, this feels a little more compact than a Bajaj Dominar. Those of you who crave a big bike feel from your first big bike will be disappointed, but there are significant upsides to the Trident's compactness as well. It not only comes across as a smaller motorcycle than the Dominar, but it also feels lighter on its feet, which will give first-time big bike owners a great sense of confidence. And sure enough, short riders will also like that seat height and just how manageable this bike feels. The riding position is nice and comfy too, with slightly rear-set pegs to show you that this is still a bike with some sporting pedigree. If you're 6 foot tall or more, you will not find that this is a very compact or cramped riding position, but there are some reminders that it is for shorter riders. For example, my knees tend to rest on these extensions on the fuel tank, and if you've got big boots, they will hit the rear pillion foot peg holders. The Trident packs a new 3-cylinder engine that's designed to gel with the easy nature of this bike. This engine produces just over 80 horsepower, which ensures that it's a properly quick motorcycle, but without feeling overwhelmingly so. On paper, this motor is the same size as the one from the international spec Street Triple S, but Triumph says that they have significantly reworked the internals, and you'll believe that when you ride it, because this engine performs quite differently to the Street Triples. The Triumph 3-cylinder engine is an instrument of joy, and this new one makes all the right sounds and feelings that we've grown to love from the Street Triple. However, the power delivery is quite different, and this one is absolutely linear all the way to the 10,000 RPM redline. It's completely missing that manic top end that we've also grown to love from the Street Triple. The Trident's engine also doesn't feel as quick revving or immediately responsive as its bigger brothers, and that sort of goes with the character of the bike. Thankfully, this remains a very tractable engine, and you can easily hold high gears at low speeds without having to frequently downshift. That makes a Trident a pleasure to lazily ride around at slow speeds. Another positive to the more relaxed tune of this motor is that the service intervals are at an impressive 16,000 kilometers. However, it's worth noting that you still have to get the bike serviced at least once a year, and a regular service costs about 9,000 rupees, which is around the same as the Street Triple. As for engine heat, there certainly will be some, but we can't really give you a clear answer until the summer months return. Overall, the Trident has the makings of what could be a very nice bike even within city limits, but there are a few issues. First of all, the clutch starts to feel rather heavy when you get stuck in stop-start traffic, and the accelerator also feels a little heavier than it needs to be. Mostly though, Triumph needs to work on the low RPM fueling. Now this is something they usually get spot on, but with the Trident, when you open the accelerator at low speeds, there is a delay followed by a noticeable surge as the motor crosses about 3000 RPM. It's not really dangerous, but it's something you will constantly notice if you're going through heavy traffic. Another area where Triumph excels is in the chassis department, and the Trident is pretty good here too. But again, it's a different experience from the Street Triple. While that bike gets an aluminium chassis and swing arm, those components are made out of steel on the Trident. This motorcycle also has a slightly longer wheelbase and a more relaxed steering geometry, although all this probably won't mean much to the average rider.
Wow, What you will notice is that while the Trident is happy to flow through a set of corners at pretty high speeds, it doesn't have its bigger brother's addiction for apexes. Don't get me wrong, this bike feels light, nimble, confident, and it's good fun too. But the riding position and the general character of the motorcycle tend to keep you settled in the seat rather than hanging off and going into full-on corner attack mode. Push the bike hard and you'll also find yourself wishing for more revs, and with its short gearing, you'll be saying hello to that rev limiter quite often. Another hint at this bike's handling character is that there is no sport mode, just road and rain. More so, the traction control feels tailored to newer riders and it's far too intrusive, cutting the power on corner exits even on a perfectly dry surface with plenty of grip available from the Michelin Road 5 tyres. I usually just leave the systems on most motorcycles, but with the Trident, the traction control needed to be turned off for the faster riding shots. On the plus side, the Showa suspension is set up really well, even though you only get pre-road adjustability at the rear. It feels well controlled around the corners, but also allows for a slightly firm but pretty good ride quality for a bike like this. Of course, we're in the middle of the monsoon, and that means you're far more likely to encounter roads that look like this instead of beautifully smooth tarmac. The Trident seems to do just fine on completely broken roads as well, with decent enough ground clearance for you to get through some pretty terrible surfaces without much stress.
Ultimately, this is a very easy bike to get along with. It's pretty comfortable for a sporty naked, and it's nice to ride at slow speeds. It is also pretty entertaining if you take it out on a faster ride through some corners, but you can't shake the feeling that all-out performance is not the top priority of this motorcycle.
Clearly, the Trident is aimed at riders looking for their first big bike, and to be successful at that, it needs to look good. It manages to do that quite well, despite the unusual shape of its fuel tank. The best looking angle though is that beautifully clean tail section, thanks to the smartly designed indicator holder. The pillion seat also turned out to be more comfortable than it looks. Quality is another thing that Triumph excels at, and the Trident is no different. Things like the powerful LED lighting, the self-cancelling indicators, and the simple but smart-looking TFT display give this bike a classy feeling. Those mirror-polished foot peg holders also look great, although your boots will quickly scuff up the finish on the heel guard. There are some areas where the cost control is evident, like the simple mirrors, the basic-looking levers, and the switch gear, but even here, nothing feels cheap or compromised. In terms of rider assists, you get basic ABS and traction control, but nothing more, although you can purchase a bi-directional quick shifter as an optional accessory. In India, the Trident costs just under 7 lakh rupees ex showroom, although the colour scheme we have here adds about 13,000 rupees to the price. That positions it above the Kawasaki Z650, but a good deal below the Triumph Street Twin, and a very good deal below the new Honda CB650R, which is this bike's direct rival. There's no doubt that this pricing is tempting, but is the Trident the right bike for you?
I think it's important to understand what the Triumph Trident is and who it's aimed at. If you're someone who loves speed and all-out performance, you're looking to upgrade from something like a sporty KTM, I suspect you might quickly outgrow what this bike has to offer. However, if you're someone who loves the idea of an easy, mellow, big bike, but you also really want a smooth and sporty sounding multi-cylinder engine, I think you'll really like what the Trident has to offer.
Move, 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 move! Arey, yaar!
Hari putter. Now, unfortunately, the results.
Okay, that's safe.
Yeah. Rishad the savior.
Ride and shoot and rescue mission in one day. Well done.